Okay, so apparently came back from the couple days of vacation I took, and for some reason the memory card in the GoPro acted goofy, and right in the middle of the filming of this, actually right at the last probably 5 minutes, 10 minutes, it quit recording. It took a still picture instead of recording, and that's when the memory card screwed up and it didn't film the rest of this transmission or the Honda I was doing. So if that upsets you and you don't get to see enough of this and it's not a full rebuild, and you might not want to watch this video, but I think it's going to get you enough that you can do what you need to do. Odds of me getting another one of these transmissions in here are very, very slim. So if I ever do get one, I can finish filming it, but I doubt that's going to happen. So I'm going to go over here and show you the rest of what we got on the transmission on a picture and explain it to you, and then we'll go from there. All right, 4T40, yeah, 4T40, 440T4, it's a late unit. We're a far cry from where we started out. Nobody's got anything. Customer just wants it put back together as best we can and try to make it work. Now, I don't know, the valve body is just seized up. Gonna have a heck of a time with that. So we're gonna do the best we can. I'm not getting most of the parts that we wanted. I did get a bushing kit, but the bushing kit that came did not have this bushing here in it. I could not replace this bushing here. Something else. What was the other one? Don't remember now, right off the top of my head. Now you got these two seals that come in the kit. We want the big one that goes down to the bottom. Lip's gonna face down. You're gonna get your scribe up underneath it and roll it around it to make sure that it's not rolled over. So let me get this down in there. Let's see if we can get a shot of it. Okay. Getting up in there now and rolling it around the lip seal, make sure it's not rolled over. And right above that is an O-ring. You can pull that O-ring out. Put that down in there. And above that, right in here, is another lip seal. I'm gonna pull that one off. I'm gonna leave it off until I get done here. There's a check ball down inside there. Make sure it rattles around. And I'm out of lube. That up in there. And we got this lip seal. that up really good. Drop this down into there, just kind of twist it, and it should drop all the way down to the bottom. As long as you got plenty of lube on it and your lip seals aren't rolled. Emma, drop down in there. There we go. Alright, then we're going to line up this opening here, kind of halfway in one of these ribs on each side. And we got the spring cage. You got a narrow side and a wide side. The wide side goes up, and this container goes in there. The snap ring goes on top. You see the taper. There's a taper of the tips. You want the taper up. Took my new one and threw it away. Then we got the short lip seal. And a smaller, the lip's still going to go down. This one here, you really have to watch that you didn't roll the lip because it's so small. And we get this lip seal here. You got to be careful that these don't get pushed down so far it can pinch the seal where you can't get it in there. They also will come off, so make sure it ain't loose, and make sure that check ball's loose again. Make sure it rattles. Yeah. Put some lube on the situation down in there. Go. And we got this spring cage. The notch is going to fit where that little check ball sticks up. And you got another one of these snap rings, taper the tips up. And we did get a washer kit, so we're going to use that. Four tab washer goes on the back. Some grease to hold it on there. Just line the tabs up and push it on. Then we got a flat steel. One-sided clutches. Outside teeth first, inside teeth next. Just alternate. Set of clutches too many they sent us. Hopefully they gave us the right clutches on this one. There's early and late, so gotta make sure that they give you the right stuff. There's a thin snap ring, so I'm gonna go on here. That's about right. And we got this steel. It's got the step on the teeth. The step goes down. I guess we should have checked our clutches against our sprags. At least this set is right, so the other set's probably right. We got the notch on these teeth. We're going to line up all the notches together. Flat snap ring here. Alright, looking good. got the selective washer, goes here. This bearing here goes on top. Cut these sealing rings off. Could probably leave them if they fit in the support tight enough. You know, don't really need to change these. I make a lip seal tool, sealing ring tool for this. I believe this one come from ATEC. If you don't have the tool, you can just take these and you can stretch them out by hand until you can get them down in the groove, and then just kind of mash them in. I'm going to do that anyway because these get kind of stretched out anyway. See how stretched out it is? And it actually went too far. And you just take them and kind of mesh them back into the groove, kind of center it. There for just a second. Go ahead and do the back side here. Put our two-tab washer on here. Pull our expanders out. The early style of these drums did not have these cutouts here for these vest bell rings, and they would rotate. If you have that style, which I doubt you're ever going to see one, but you may. If you have that style, go have it machined so that you can put this on there. Unless you can find a drum, or I mean a support. Okay, so you had the, these are the ones that didn't have the expanders. If you had the drum that had those metal rings, you definitely don't want it. Now this one goes to the servo. And then they had, if I remember right, they had brown and black. So many things I've forgotten on this unit. Some of it's coming back to mind. Make sure your expander's not rolled. Definitely wanting to roll on me. Alright. I think we're straight now. Then you want to put the expanders in. And then this goes sitting like that. And these little tabs go in these notches. Make sure it's clipped in there all the way. All right, now that we got that on there, This is a resizer for this. Now, I don't leave this on there. And the reason I don't do that anymore is because it seems to make it too small. So I'll shove it on there to resize it. And then I take the support and I slide that over and let it resize to the support. There we go. And I'll just leave that there until it's ready to assemble. Take the slip seal off. And make sure that this bearing is driven down. Sometimes when it gets hot in the cleaning machine, it'll slide out. Lip down. And I remember something about the support, about the shape of this right here. I don't remember what it is. I'm going to look all this stuff up. Because I'm not going to be able to edit this video anytime soon. So I'm going to go back and find out what all this stuff was. Odds of me doing another 440. Pretty dang slim, especially after this one where we couldn't get any parts. And I think the manager will probably shy away from doing another one. So we got these two half moons here. One's gonna line up right there, one's gonna line up right there. That'll get you pretty dang close. Be careful, this stuff right here, you got some sharp edges, it will cut the crap out of you. This return spring, take one of our tips up, just shove it in there and work it around. Ready to assemble this. This four tab washer, it's going to sit on top right there. I'm going to go put this away. Let's see, we've got our hardened shell. And this plant's going to sit on top of that. This top hat washer goes here. This bearing goes on top of that. This plant sits on top of that. This bearing goes in there. Band drum goes on there. Our support goes on there. This bearing goes on top of our support here. This bearing goes on the back of the support. Park gear is going to go on there. This shaft is going to go with the small end forward. Actually, it goes, it needs to go in first. This needs to go on there. The recessed end goes down on our differential sun gear. This bearing goes on our differential. Down in, yep. Wrong one. This bearing here goes in the back of there. And our selective washer. And this bearing goes on there. That sits on there. Okay. our second drum. They were running this unit today and I don't think they're going to get it. That valve body is just horrible. I think I'm going to take every valve out of it. Alright. Lip seals go facing towards you. Piston goes in just like that. If you get one of these units that's got just a lot of junk, it gets really packed up inside those ribs there. So it can be kind of difficult to get out. All right, we've got our return spring. This end is going to face up. We've got a flat snap ring. Push it all the way in until it clicks into place. Alright. We got our wavy plate. Steel. And our clutches. These are choline steels. They still got some of the choline on them. When they start turning silver, the choline's pretty much gone. And that choline will help make a smoother shift. Once it turns all silver, you're going to get kind of a bumpy shift. There's several different of these pressure plates that go on top up here. This one just happens to be like this. Clicked in. Alright, here we go. And let's see what else. We've got our servo lip seal here. Our O-ring. This servo. This one takes that sealing ring. And you can put grease on this to hold it in there if you want to. And we want that together just like that. And I take it and I tweak it just a little bit. It helps keep it up in the groove. Clutch. If I remember right, I don't remember if they ever had a two clutch. I know they sent me two clutches, but I don't know. Something just didn't seem right about it. Seemed like there was maybe there's a thick one clutch and then there was a thin two clutches. All right, we want this hole to line up with the hole. come on in. So whoever had it before didn't have it lined up properly. There we go. Want this washer. This sprag, the grooves face up. And here again, we want to line up the oil hole. And then we got this one. This faces up. You want to make sure it's turning counterclockwise, locking clockwise. This one's turning clockwise, locking counterclockwise. I think we're ready to go in case. I'm going to change camera angles, probably change battery. All right, down here in the bottom, make sure that that bushing isn't sitting above that surface. Go ahead and stick your park rod in. Always check this and make sure this is not beaten off, and because this will slide forward and it'll be stuck in park. It's a pretty common problem. ...15 millimeter nut. Had to film this one on the Verb. We put our differential in there. I've got the GoPros taken up with the Honda that I'm waiting on parts. Sun gear. Park gear. Our support with our park facing the rod there. There we go. And our snap ring. Camera's kind of right in the way. All right. Gonna lube up the ends of our tubes here. I think I did that backwards. Big one goes in first and the small one. All right, then our small band. And we want also this little stop in here for your band to line up, that little black thing down there. If it's not in the case, you're supposed to put one in there. And these 2 feet stick on those two pins sticking out there. Make sure you're lined up. All right. And our drum. Plan it. Now, if I remember right, the output shaft needs to go in now. You got this. If there weren't flats on here, you were supposed to grind flats on it, 4 of them on each end. And this cage bearing goes on here. So like so. There we go. Now, I happen to have the tool, so it's going to be easier for me if you don't have the tool. You want to make sure and do this before you get too far, because if you pop this clip up inside the tranny and you can't get it back out, you're going to have to take it back apart to get to it. So, put the clip on the end of that shaft in the differential here. Remember who makes it. I don't remember where I got it. It says J-34757 KM USA. Put this on here. Shell down with the little tabs here facing down. The drum. Reach in here, kind of hold that shell still and just wiggle it back and forth and it'll go down. Want this bend on top. This facing that way. These two are going to go on those lugs right there. Support. We want this facing this way. Now, I don't remember what this measurement's supposed to be. We're pretty much right there, I can tell you. I'll find out what it was supposed to be. I'll tell you what this one is. 17 thousandths. And we got our oil down. Just turn this until it goes in there. There we go. We got our drive sprocket. Four tab washer that goes on there. You don't want these sticking up too far. If they do, go grind them down. We want the colored link of our chain facing up. Different tooth counts of these sprockets and combination of your sun gear and your differential. It will determine your gear ratio of this tranny. Four tab washer on top. Fourth hub. It says DN, that means down. It's the thick one. Two on there, make sure this half moon is lining up on this part right here. If it's not, just turn it. Another steel. A fourth clutch. and our other steel. Flat file this whole area here. I got a builder's bench stone. These gaskets are horrible about blowing out, so you want this as flat as it can be. We got this spring goes up here. Make sure we're getting all this up here. This spring goes here. Got our dowel pin here. Got those sitting back. Got another dowel pin up here in this corner. And we gotta get our channel plate ready. And I should have done that before we came over here, but I didn't, so. I got this bearing here, pops in right here. Three tab washer going in right here. This accumulator going in here. May have to put some grease on it to keep it in there. That fits a little loose. I think it's giving me another seal. See if this one fits tighter. Yeah, that one fits much better. And get you some Scotch-Brite. Go ahead and Scotch-Brite your accumulator bores in here and on the back side of the case, and your servo bores. Get all that ready to go. Right in here, there's a valve. And I don't remember what the number is, but I'll get it. There's a valve in here. Make sure it's free. And there's a clip. When there's a two-piece valve, there's a clip that holds the two pieces together. Make sure that clip isn't broken and the two pieces are moving together. There was also a deal about this orifice in here. If it wasn't in there, you're supposed to put that in there. I'll find all that information. I keep mine all together and I just put it all on at one time. Instead, of this does disconnect right here, but it's a pain. So I just do it this way, and I loop it in there. And make sure that we're good to go. I forgot my gaskets, like a dummy. You can also glue these down if you want to. We got this one. Make sure that these passages line up. You can use dowel pins to, or guide bolts to keep this all in place. That's what I used to do. But sometimes they get in the way. I'll just leave them there if they will stay in place. If they won't, then I deal with it. All right, let's see if we can get this down on there. The sealing rings that are on that sprocket, they're the same as the support. If you can have resistance, there's no need to change the things, but if it just falls in the bore, then I would change them. We got a bunch of these 40 Torx. These. Going in here. Strange bolt goes right here. Alright, 40 Torx on all that. We'll make sure and get these bolts tight. Especially these ones that go here on the gasket. Because like I said, the gasket was super bad about blowing out. Especially right up here. Let's see, I don't remember if I tightened that one down or not. Got our accumulator pins. Make sure, don't forget to put those in there. shaft off because we can't do our valve body right now. Make sure that you grab your sprocket and turn it. If it won't turn, then take a punch and get right here. Get right there and just give it a couple whacks and it'll knock that down. That means you forgot to push that bearing back down. We'll go ahead and put our seal in here. Crappy seals from Toledo. Go ahead and do this because we may not get to do it. I may do this while I'm gone. I'm fixing to take a few days of vacation, so if I'm not able to get that valve body done, they may send it to somebody else and get it done. Good. No, I have to do the valve body. Can't do all this yet. The brackets hold that. Let me go do the valve body and see if I can get it free. Okay. Right down in this hole right here, there's a screen. It's got this flat spot on it. It goes in with the flat spot facing this way. You want to make sure this thing is nice and free. And it fits pretty snug. Let's see if we can get it pushed back down in there. Come on, baby. Here we go. And make sure we're pushed all the way down flat past the channel here. We don't want it sticking up. There we go. Now we're all the way down. Up in this area right here, I got these two seals that go in. Drive them in flush, and you want to put a little lube on them. Those pipes have to push into there. There's a spring that goes in right here. I'm gonna have to find the number for it. There's an update for that spring. This is a different valve body. Miracle of all miracles, when a valve body was not available the other day, nobody had it anywhere and could never get it. All of a sudden, when I was unable to make the other valve body work, all of a sudden this one shows up. So 85 models had four check balls, one here, quarter inch, here, here, and here. In 85 and a half, they added a 3/8 ball that goes right there. Always change your lockup solenoid. Make damn sure that the throttle valve is free. And on your valve body channel plate gaskets, or separator plate gaskets, there's two different ones. If you notice how that hole right there is plugged, or it's not plugged, but it's not open. So that's the wrong gasket, and then there's a matching gasket for it that's gonna be wrong. And we have the right gaskets. And you'll notice there's a this cutout here. Goes around your thermal valve, so this gasket goes on this side. But you can see that neither one of these gaskets is blocking or restricting that hole now. So these are the gaskets that we need. And this little orifice deal right here is for lockup. Even if this thing is in good shape, always replace it. There's a little O-ring that goes on it. Make sure that you got that on there and it's in good shape. And I think it was in this way. Make sure before I pop that in there, I got this going the right way. Yeah, I do. It's got a little rib on it and it just pops into place. All right, we're gonna change camera angles now. Before we do that, we got 8 check balls. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Got our dowel pin, goes in here. And we're gonna have to put our detent back on. Got one of these 27 Torx bolts. This little tip fits down in that hole. Make sure we're centered on the rooster comb. The pump shaft, it has one of these scarf cuts from the factory. If in the kit they give you a solid one, it's fine. Just resize it and make sure, you know, you don't cut it when you put it down in the hole. Watch the bearing that rides on the pump shaft. It goes down in here. They are fairly bad about eating up. Alright, we want the gasket. It has this cut out in it down first. And our channel plate, our separator plate. And our other gasket. We have to hold the tubes back. I guess we could air check it first. We do have to put the servo in. Let me go ahead and leave this here so the check balls don't fall out. Just put one bolt in so it doesn't fall off. I'll turn this up. Turn this up where I can get to the servo. Put a little lube on the situation. I don't know how well this is going to come out on here. I'm going to look down inside there and make sure our band is centered. Not, we'll just move it into place. We want the servo that has the lip seal on it. We've already changed. Lube it up a little bit. Our spring sits down inside this little pocket right here. A little lube on our servo cover. We're gonna put our clip on. We want at least some of it over in here. It makes it easier to get it back out if you put it to where you can get up in this groove. Pop the snap ring off. Oh, come on now. Make dang sure it's all the way up in that groove. All right. Flip this back over. Okay, we needed to take this back off anyway. Valve body. It gave us an updated spring for the lockup valve, so we need to put that in. Didn't even notice that until just now. Here's the spring that they gave us. And it's gonna go, they're showing it on this valve right here, but I'm thinking it's for this one, but I'll get a eyeball on it. Kit is showing the spring to go on this valve, but this is not the spring that we always replaced, and it will not fit, but it will fit this valve. So I'm putting it on the valve that we always put it on. You see, it won't go in there. But it will fit over this valve. And like I said, this, the spring that we used to always replace, it caused a shutter. Here's the original spring. Here's the end plug. You want the rounded end facing in. And this clip likes to beat up on this plug, so you might have to do some cleaning up on the groove where the clip fits in order to get it to come out and to go back in properly. So you just pop the clip in, and then your lockup valve or solenoid goes on. It's got two tins that hold it on. Take this over here and tighten it down. Take our gasket and plate back off in order to air check this. Make sure the dowel pin stays in there. All right, we may need a plate. These we can check. This is fourth clutch. Second is down in here. Third. And input clutch. I don't know if we can get down in there. Have to get something here. I don't have a plate big enough, and this pipe He's just not gonna get it. Doesn't look like. Okay, I can hear it. If it's applying with all that air leaking around that pipe, it's gonna apply otherwise. And our reverse servo is up here. Plate back on, plate in our gaskets. Put our valve body back down. Put our tubes back. These 30 Torx look like that. Two of them go right there. We got these 30 Torx with these brackets. Fit right. Right here. Goes right there. We got these 230 Torx go here. We got these 313s that go down here. And the bracket, if I remember right, goes right here. Come on now. Let's see. And you got 27 torx with this bracket here. You want these little feet facing in. Go ahead and put our other servo in if we want to air check it. If we air check it right there. And down inside this tube right here, it's got the rubber seals on it, but they're longer. You go down here, there's a capsule in there. What we need to be looking at. Down inside this tube right here, and there's that rubber seal. There's a rubber seal on each of these. But underneath that rubber seal, there's a capsule like on the 4L60 and 4L60Es. And it takes a different puller. Apparently somebody relieved me of it. Tech Pack Fits All makes it just like for the 4L60. We got the Teflon sealing ring in there. Here's our spring. Here again, it's got a pocket that it fits down into. Putting a little grease on here to help keep it kind of centered. Doesn't hurt at all. All right, lube up our cap. To have everything down here when you start this. All right. I'm gonna flip this back up. Here and servo apply. And servo release. They got that wrong. This is apply. Let's see if we can get that plugged off. And release. Pump. We're going to have to rewire all this. All the wires are messed up. We got a filter in here. Guess we ought to go ahead and replace that. You can leave this out if you want to. Oh, come on now. Got a valve in here, and need to make sure it's free. That filter just pops into place. We got these two 13s that go on the top. And this 30 Torx goes down here. I just line up where the channel marks are. We got this O-ring, fits right here. Got our metal ring. Got our metal guide rings. The rotor, the recessed end faces down. Make sure those splines are really good. There'd be marks on your vanes right there where the guide rings have been riding. Just put those facing the same way. Got another guide ring. Got a rubber seal that goes up inside there. Lube this up a little bit. This pops into there. And this sits down. Make sure that that guide is in there. Got this gasket, make sure this is facing right up here. Got 27 Torx, goes in the corner up here. Torx, 30 Torx. Then we got 340 Torx. And I'm forgetting which bolt goes down here, that's why I'm waiting on it. Is 10 millimeter. Early models did not have this tube coming across here. The plate over here took this gasket, and if I remember right, it sat that way. But just pay attention to how it came off and put it back exactly the same way, because you need it to cover the port. Otherwise, you're not gonna get any apply there. Your throttle valve linkage has this looped in. This goes in right here. It's gonna stick up in this hole over here. Comes out through the top of the case. This little dowel pin fits right inside there. We got our 30 Torx and our bracket for our wiring harness. There's a bracket goes here, I forgot about. Leave this 10 here, it was right there. Okay, I'm gonna have to rewire all this. All these wires are messed up. So I'll get that done. And then we'll come back. We'll be putting the side cover on. Wiring harness just clips in. You got this little tab right here that faces inwards. Wires are going to hook in this bracket here. We got, looks to be a gray wire, green wire, tan wire. All these were different depending on what you had. This goes into here, wiring harness clips in, and there's a little tab that faces up that this lines up with. You had different, you had four wire and you had five wire depending on what your application was, what the year was. So I'm going to get that all that on there. I'm going to go ahead and put the side cover on. There's no need to see me doing that, just a gasket goes on here, and of course the side cover gasket goes on here. These things were fairly bad about leaking. If you want to put some silicone on there or some gasket sealer, you can. It just makes it harder to clean it up when you go back into it. Just make sure your pan is straight. What you might want to do is get your pan. See if we can get a. This is going to turn so I can show you. Get your pan on the edge of a table, like so. And just kind of straighten it out a little bit. They tend to get bent. People over torque them all the time. Just do that all the way around. And once I get that all done, we will come back. I'll There is one other thing to show you. It goes in here. I almost forgot to put it in. This oil dam goes right down here. Here we go. Other than that, I don't think we have anything else to show in here, so we'll be back. Alright. I got this little contraption here, this little spring. Sits right down in there. Tube goes up in here. Got this flat rubber seal, sits on top. You got your two accumulators and pins and springs. Make sure that's a little loose down in there. Might ought to try to tighten that up. But you got your springs, one's large, one's small. The long one goes in the long hole, short one goes in the short hole. And there used to be something about these accumulator pins. Let me see if I can go find that. Lathe cut seals go on here, make sure they're not rolled. Alright, let me go see if I can find that. Alright, let's see if we can get through this before the battery dies. So where we left off was right here. I was going to find how to repair this. I never did find that. But I finally remembered that I used to use the cut plugs we used in 4T60 and 4L60s for the capsule that you pull out of the case. So drilled that hole where the pin goes to with the 362 thousandths drill bit. Drove the cut plug in there all the way. The pins fit really nice and tight. Long spring goes here, short spring goes here. The accumulators are the same. Change your seal out for your filter gasket plate, and another gasket goes on top. This is your thermal valve. Make sure that little plate is underneath there. There's an oil scoop that goes here. The bracket holds the two pipes in place. It also, this has a pipe that comes down here for lube. There's a clip. You clip it on each side of the case. Usually put it in at an angle right here on this side first, and then you can pop this side in easier. The gasket goes here. Make sure it's in the right way. Other than that, I don't think there's nothing there. This is that lineup plug or anchor for the band. If you don't have the wide band, that has to be in there. If you have the wide band, that's going to be in the way. You need to take that out. The governor comes in from the other side. Make sure that you're, when you push the weights, that the ball falls on its own. It doesn't get stuck in there. The governor gears on top. This one was electric. And if it's a cable driven, they got different gears. They also have different rotors for the electric ones for your speedometer, so make sure that you match all that up. Let's see if there was anything else. lever seal on the top. If you when you have all this out of the side and that linkage out of there, you can pull that nail out and pull the pin out and change it that way, or you can use the tool that you got for 4T60Es to change it also, or even 4L60s, the long one. There was long and short of these also. If I remember correctly, there was. Let's see, I'm trying to remember if there was anything else that this didn't pick up on. I think that was it. My battery's going, so I think that was all. If I remember anything else, I'll come back. Alright, this is some of the stuff that I could come up with remembering off the back of my memory. Some of the things that we talked about: always use a center support for with the best bell rings. The pump shaft solid ring, if that doesn't come in the kit, you can use a 4L60 input drum sealing ring. That's the same. The updated TCC regulator spring to prevent shutter from Transtar, it's 84741C-3. There's our servo travel that needs to be. I don't have the tools for checking it. It's a pain to check. Here's the servo pins that they offer for the different bands. Now, if you go to the updated wide band, there's only one pin, and it's this one. And if you have the F7 model, which was the Cadillac, if I remember correctly, it had that one. And then same with the 1-2 servo. There's only, if you use the updated wideband, there's only one pin for each one. And you had to remove the plastic band stop that's in the case right by the band. If you don't have that wideband, do not remove that plastic stop. The 3-2 line control valve I showed you in the channel plate, where the clip likes to break, there's the GM number for it, if it's still the same. The cut plug for the accumulator pin repair that I showed you from Transtar is F54483A. There's different change and different sprockets. You got to match the chain to the sprocket. There's round pins, which the chain pretty much just folds in on itself. The rocker style is like a rigid style chain. You can't fold it up. It'll stay lengthwise. And you have to use the sprockets for that style chain. There's two different clutch support housings. They're not interchangeable. Second clutch housings, there's the lip seal style, and then there's a molded piston style like the 4T60E. They are not interchangeable. You need to match the park rod when you take it out. Make sure it's the same length, got the same bends and everything in it. There's two different updated supports. The very early support had a long oil scoop that went in there with it. The late one had a short one. And the late one looks very similar to the 4T60E, and it is not the same. Do not put that in there. The channel plate, I forgot to mention that. On the channel plate, there's a number, and the reason I forgot to mention it is mine, the one I had, it was a 827, I believe, which you can swap the 827 out for this one. And I used to not even pay attention. As long if it had that number, I didn't even look for the E. I just swapped it out for an 827. But if you have an A, B, C, or D, you can reuse it. The E was bad, you needed to update it, and it takes a different manual valve, link, and rooster cone, so you got to swap all that stuff out. The E, the number for the 8668423 will be on the channel plate over by where the bolts for the inner gasket go. That's where that number is. If you go to the other side of the channel plate, where there's those three bolts that are in a triangle bolt down, there, that's where that letter will be. That's where you need to look for that at. Starting in 1990, some had the 2/4 clutches. Do not try to upgrade that to put two clutches in there. It will not work. You will have a problem. If you want to measure the end play, I told you when we were rebuilding it to check that distance there. That distance is supposed to be 6 to 12 thousandths. And then that cut plug I mentioned in the channel plate that they would add was to cure modulator valve buzz. That's the GM number if it's still the same, and if you can still get it, 8646987. I'm sure there's some other stuff in there that I don't remember. Any questions, you know, you can just contact me, and I'm sure I can find the information out for you. I got a ton of information on the 440 because they had so many problems with it. So I guess that's it for this one. All right, another thing, that cut plug, but that end plug where we changed the spring gets screwed up. If they're still selling it, 8649434 is the plug, and the clip is 8656727.